Hi everyone, in today's video, I'm taking you on a short trip to Siem Reap. It's been 3 years since COVID-19 that I'm there, so I decided to explore this beautiful city all over again. Upon arriving, I stayed at the Lub D Hostel and Hotel, as I wanted to try a new place for the next 2 days. While it's known as a hostel, with a hotel vibe, catering to the young crowd, I had a pleasant stay. It's also an excellent choice for families or large group of friends with private room available and is wallet friendly. Before heading to Siem Reap, I was appointed the managing director of Feel Good Coffee and someone who I've known for 10 years since the brand opened in 2013.
Jurepso everyone, and hello. My name is Song Kong. I does operating managing for some of our businesses in Phnom Penh and Siem Reap also, and we got some cafe in Batamo as well.
While I was there, I got to experience the amazing coffee brand firsthand in Siem Reap, which opened 8 to 9 months ago. It was a treat for a coffee lover like me, or in my case, a refresher course to learn about coffee. In the food and beverage industry, we always have to keep on learning like any other industry. As you may know, every coffee brand has its own coffee master with unique techniques of making coffee. At the beginning, I was introduced to the roaster room, the process, and types of coffee bean they use.
Hello everyone, welcome to our roasting house. Here's where we roast the coffee, which is behind Brother Bong Cafe. Then we supply to hotel, cafe, and restaurant. Like Brother Bong Cafe, we create a special lunch for Brother Bong. If you want to come and try, please come and ask for a cup of coffee. I would like to introduce you to three different coffee beans that we're using here at Siem Reap. So first is Cambodia, that we're taking from Mundokiri. Second is Thailand, that we're taking from Chiang Rai. The third is Vietnam, that we're taking from Dala.
What is the estimate time that you think it would be perfect for roasting?
We usually use 200 degree temperature, which is, I think, the best for coffee.
Okay.
Some kind of the roaster, you can heat up to 220. So you will roast coffee shorter, it will dry the coffee faster.
So and normally how long would it take this process?
Normally we spend from 12 minutes to 20 minutes.
Okay.
Depending on what kind of profile.
Okay.
Yeah. Some of the coffee we roast 12 and a half minutes. Some of the coffee we roast 15 minutes. Some of the coffee we roast 18 minutes.
On the side note, stay tuned to my upcoming video, the full process, how Figo Coffee Roaster roasting their coffee beans at their Phnom Penh location. In Cambodia, coffee beans grown in the mountainous area of Mundokiri, which is mainly Robusta, getting international recognition through many coffee companies like Feel Good Coffee Roaster promoting it. Next, I'm with Sakpot, the operation manager and coffee roaster at Siem Reap, explain the subsequent step of coffee cupping to me after the bean being roasted.
Hello everyone, my name is Sihon Rose. Today, I'm a beer guide to when the guiding for the coffee experience for you.
The purpose of cupping is quality control. This ensures that each roasted batch maintaining a certain quality, according to the coffee profile for their signature blend or for their customer before it's packed and shipped. Last but not least, before I go to my next destination, that is what chocolate factory tour, which will be featured in my future video. I was taught how to make my own coffee using dripping method, at home using their special Feel Good blend. which is a mix of Monokiri Robusta bean with Arabica beans. Okay. It's blend from Dalat and Chiang Rai. It was a total learning for me, and at the same time, I share my experience in marketing and communication in red engagement. As this coffee tasting or cupping session that I've just experienced will be their new services for tourists and locals who wish to learn more about their coffee brand. Coming to Siem Reap for the past 2 days gave me the opportunity to indulge in my favorite activities, eating local food, drinking coffee, eating chocolate, and my most favorite unwind activity, driving around Angkor Archaeology Park in the evening like the locals do here. It was a perfect getaway for me from the city life in Phnom Penh. I will certainly return to visit other F&B businesses, food producers, and manufacturers in Siem Reap. That's all for today's video. So, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the F&B channel. Until next time, happy eating and drinking.